Janet did.
No, I didn't know it's all right. Just, one thing before we start, Bonnie, you went and approached two of the board members, I don't have a problem with that.
I didn't approach two, I approached all, or I said it all three.
All right, you should go through me first, because you went and set up a meeting.
Hold on, that's not how it started. So it started because Sandy had stopped in my office, and I said to Sandy, I, Bonnie, want to meet with the selectmen, not at a meeting, just meet with them to get their input about the highway. So Sandy said, well, if you're going to do that, I'd like to be present. And then Catherine happened to stop in on Friday too, and said the same thing. So that's why I approached them yesterday, and said, well, you want to talk to us.
Right, and that's.
And you need to understand, your role is chairman. What a chairman's role is that you chair this meeting.
Right, and if you had a problem.
I didn't, I tried to call you. I tried to call you, and Pam answered the phone, and I chose not to leave a message, because I know sometimes it's hard for her to relay it to you. So I did try to call you, but you weren't home. And I emailed you.
I got the email.
And that was before I even talked to these people. I just talked to them yesterday.
Is it bad that we're here?
No, but the thing is, yes, she should have came to the chair, and I was never told anything until she sent me an email. I should have been, she should have came and said, Ed, can you go and approach the selectmen?
There's no reason to. I have an equal authority as you do, and so does it Catherine, so does it Jenny, and so does it Sandy. We all have the same role. You just chair a meeting. And as we're talking about this, I would also like to say that I, for one, feel really bad about the way we treat people that come in to meet with us. As a budget committee member, I see our role as working with people, not making them so angry they walk out of a meeting on us.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that way, because of
I've seen happen. I've seen three people attacked, and I don't like it. And I'm just saying that that's not why I'm sitting here. I'm sitting here to work with these people and to listen to them. And I don't think that we need a 20-minute discussion on a porta potty. You have a right to your opinion, for sure, but not 20 minutes worth that makes somebody so angry they leave.
Well, I'm sorry it wasn't 20 minutes.
It was 20. I watched on my watch.
All right, well, I'm not going to get into it with you.
That's right.
I may have also contributed to the highway department and the select board, because I felt that if Bonnie was asking them to be present, then it should have been the entire budget committee. So that's why I agreed that it was appropriate.
And I wasn't asking them to be
I'm not
present.
Saying that. Because they came, that should be in front of the whole board, not just that.
It's wonderful to be, and that's why I'm happy they're here, so that we're all hearing the same thing. But you have to understand the underlying reason for having them, asking them, is because I don't feel that any one of us on the budget committee walked away from meeting with the highway department understanding what was being asked for. How could we possibly make good decisions when we really don't know what the needs are? We do not know what the needs are.
No, but again, here you go, and you kept saying, well, we got to go zero this budget.
I did not ever say that, ever. I said we'd start from scratch with the budget, but we don't reflect on the previous years. Yes, you're right there.
Absolutely. And
that's got nothing to do with meeting the selectmen. Meeting with the selectmen is for them to say to us, I mean, Jeffrey was talking about doing paving, but he wants to pave dirt roads.
I understand that.
I have a question for the select board. Are you in agreement with it? If they're saying, and they have the final say, and Jeffrey does not. So if they're not in agreement with it, then that changes how we should vote.
I understand that.
Right.
It's just I still feel that had you wanted the select board to come here.
I didn't want them to come here, Ed. That's where you're misconstruing this. I wanted to meet with them. I didn't, not as a group.
But it started out with you, and then Sandy and Catherine and Emma, because I saved your email that you sent.
Right.
And it was like,
right.
And then you said, I've already sent a letter to Sarah asking her.
So, Ed, you were left out of the meeting? Everyone else was there?
There was no meeting.
Yes. It was talking to the select board, you were left out?
Could we get on with the meeting?
Really?
No, because I don't want to be here for mine.
No, me either.
You don't find us fun to be with?
That has nothing to do with him.
No, I'm just kidding, Jim.
Okay.
So,
I don't know, you made the agenda.
Oh, well, 6:15 was the select board's budget. I'm sorry, I don't have to turn up, though.
And have you time looking over, to look over our budget yet? Is that what you're going to do right now?
Yes.
Insurance and stuff, and well, so this.
I've got that written down.
Okay, so yeah, so but this doesn't reflect that.
No.
Okay.
So the thing on the insurance.
Insurance. The liability, the life, health insurance, and the workman's comp, we're going to have to raise. The liability we need to raise to $39,138. Health insurance has to go up to $126,000. And workers' comp has to go up to $12,773.
Thank you.
Which would take our grand total up to $416,019.
Why the jump in the insurance?
We have more employees.
We have more people going on. They're going on the two people on the family plans. We're actually adding, because Mitchell will be going on this year. As three people, and it's four single people, one person on the two-person plan, person on the family plan, it's $10,292.80 a month, which is $123,514, but then you get dental. For four people, it'd be 183.80 a month. So brought it up to the 126,000. And these are fixed numbers.
We have to have insurance, I guess, to make it appealing for people to want to work for our town.
Health Trust has looked around through their all their other companies, and this is actually the best one.
Everything else where you see there's a small increase, really that's just an increase because inflation from 2021 has been more than 17%.
You know, a lot of them just stayed the same.
Why, not that you can answer, but Jenny and Leaf maybe, why was there no contingency money last year? It was zero, and now we're...
I don't know.
Why was it taken out?
Well, they took it out, but... I explained to them why we had contingency in case there was somebody that needed extra money, and we've always kept it in there. So Russell suggested 5,000, so that's what we put in.
Yeah, I'm just curious as to why it went away to begin with. The same thing that went away that I don't see anywhere is we used to have a line item for computer support. So that if one of our computers broke or something major happened to a computer, but there's no computer account. There's software accounts and stuff, computer support, but that's not.
Right.
I mean, we used to have
it's
a computer.
It's all in the
supplies and license software.
Computer support, license software, and it's right there in supplies. License software, you can add computer support.
So I can kind of answer that. We entered into an agreement with an IT person that is a 5-year equipment plan. And the equipment is new this year. There is no reason to believe that we're going to need...
Mine is
well, I don't know, is that in your budget or is that in ours?
A new computer for... the tax collector, no, there's no money anywhere for it. So I'm just saying that we used to have
We did.
Specific
the
for,
reason
like
why we lumped it into this other one is because we thought that we had all the computers replaced.
I think my tax collector's 9 or 10 years old.
Well, enter $5,000 for contingency if your computer goes to hell.
There you go. There's a great reason why we decided contingency should have $5,000 in it.
Okay. Just like I said, we used to have that.
But you also have a contract.
I don't know why they took it out in the first place.
You have a contract balance too, don't you?
For the town clerk's computer. Well, he does do support, but
not the tax collector.
Oh, I thought you did. Well,
he does help me with it, but it's not a
good contract. Out of his heart.
Yeah, exactly.
And if you need a computer, then we deal with it. I mean, we've got the contingency.
Okay. Again, it's just a question of where that went.
Or we put $1,400 more in it, under the computer line item. Now would be the time to do it. Really, a 10-year-old computer is a dinosaur.
But we know what happened to my other computer.
Right.
I guess I had I know at one of the other meetings that you had tossed around a figure for wage increases. What was that figure that you used? What percentage?
3.7%.
3.7? Okay, thank you. Because I know some are asking for more than that.
Yeah. And they may be asking for more than that because I'm not so sure that they got wage increases since 2021. Have they religiously gotten a wage increase? Because inflation has gone up 17.7%, and I don't know that wages have, unless I look back into it.
I just know that you had tossed out a percentage, and I didn't capture what that was.
And again, wage increases really kind of like the health care. You have to be able to recruit and retain your employees. You can't keep training people and being an employee stepping stone. like a 40-year-old grader. So if you have a brand new employee that's driving it like a 2-year-old grader, it's gonna break. So that employee is gonna cost you a ton of money. You have to be able to retain your employees so that they know, even so that they know your equipment.
Doing sign-on bonuses?
We are not, as of now, no. So the, are you looking at the training or?
Well, the training up there, 300 is more than reasonable.
Yeah, I mean, training up there, I'm pretty sure that's for when Sarah wants to go and do something.
Mm-hmm. She's taking a course right now that I tried to get into but was awful.
Sure.
And the good thing is that she's willing to share that information with anybody who wants to read the material.
Yep.
So she gave it to me right now. Miscellaneous training slash training, is that going to be a change in line item or?
Well, that's under the executive.
Mm-hmm. So that would be?
So that would be
us.
If I want to go for training, not so much Sarah.
What's crop registration fees? I mean, it's not much money, but what is that?
What's it under?
Under
yeah.
Executive.
I think crop means property.
Crop, yeah.
Property, oh, yeah. For like
so
April.
Yes, it's for April.
Okay,
yep.
Gotcha.
Fees.
And we get that back, right? I mean, you charge. Oh, no, it's probably if Sarah had. I never, ever print anything,
right.
Ever.
If we deed a property or something like that, and we have to change the deed or something, I mean, it's like a $35 fee.
Okay, yeah.
I'm just throwing that out there. It could be $75, I don't know. But
it's $12 for the first page, $4
okay.
For each page after
and there,
that.
And there may actually
and
be a licensing.
$25 fee for Elchip.
Okay. And there may be a licensing fee. For her to be connected to
it. There used to be, but there isn't anymore. That's why they charge us per things we print. They didn't used to do that. Did we lock in for heating fuel?
Yes.
We did?
Yeah.
And it's gone up that much?
Not that. Heating fuel, that. Not cost. Dropped down. I thought it was 339 is what they all been at.
Yeah, it's dropped. That's why we didn't change it. We put to the 10 pounds.
It's dropped.
Oh yeah, we still have a few months after this.
I know that sometimes in the past, if the welfare department had a client that needed heating fuel and we couldn't get anybody else to deliver it, what we would do is call the town's supplier and have them go.
Is it next year that we're going to be required to do a town-wide evaluation?
I guess 2025.
2025.
Mm-hmm.
workman's compensation is, how does that figure get set?
Through a work health department.
Like if somebody needs workman's comp.
It's so much per hundred, both what the town pays out in labor. That's what workers' comp is set. Give you an example, when I was in business, I had to pay $21 per hundred for roofing workers' comp. So that's actually a very, very good number. I mean, I used to pay that with just a handful of guys, never mind the whole town.
Yes.
I think so, thank you.
All right, so let's go to that. Do you have any agenda next?
Well, I think.
Yes, if you've got nobody else, talk to someone.
Sure.
So Russell, did you get the recommendations that?
I did, but I don't have them with me.
You don't have them with you?
I do, never mind. I have the requested amount, is that what you're talking about?
Well, I was talking about the ones that Leaf presented to.
Oh, I have those.
Good.
I've got three different copies here.
Me too, I have too many here, don't know. So some of the things that I had questions about was, for instance, chloride. So on the thing that we were presented by Lee, he said to drop it down to 8. Jeffrey, actually, when he met with us, he said we could drop it to 6,000 and he'd be comfortable with that. But also I heard that he already just recently purchased, I don't remember how many gallons, but a lot. So is there a reason, I'm asking, do you think, to, well, I mean, is this in hopes of going the following year? Because he said he didn't use it.
There lies the problem with asking people to fill out an Excel spreadsheet for their budget. Nobody knows. We don't know unless you physically go down there and look in the highway department for calcium chloride. We're not going to know. Not only that, but we're also not going to know what it costs. First two lines have $10,000 stuck in there, right? Calcium chloride and culverts. Both of them, there was nothing spent. It looks to me like it's an arbitrary number just thrown in a line.
Well, he told us the other night that he did order more culverts, that he hadn't paid the bill yet. So that would, there would be a figure put in there. But then I asked, well, if you already ordered them, why are you seeking money for next year?
If they're going to be paid for this year.
Well, exactly, and that's what he said. He was waiting for the bill to come in. Well, it's not going to take 3 months to build commitment.
No, they should come in within a couple of weeks. So
right. So that's why I'm asking. Here's two lines right away, $20,000. That do we really? I mean, if he needs it, he needs it. But
look, we know that the roads are not in great condition. We know that it takes culverts to keep this town functioning. If we don't put money in there, then we're just doing harm to the rest of people.
Oh, for sure. But if he's already got them.
The problem is we don't know what to put in there because we just have a random number thrown down there and we don't have anything to say, hey, this is what a culvert costs. And this is how many culverts I need. Or
can
I need
to do this, Russ. I don't know if you saw this or not.
But also calcium chloride is in the right.
Is it what
is needed? If the luxury to keep stuff down on Spirit Road. That's all Kelsey and Corey do for. He has a full tank.
Well, if you have asthma or you have COPD and you live on a dirt road and he happens to put calcium chloride in front of your house, that is a great relief.
It is. It also holds the dirt in place on hills around corners where people tend to chop. It gets choppy. It holds it in place. The problem that I have is I never saw any calcium chloride getting
there. Was none on my road.
I don't know if
he used to put it in front of.
Well, I mean,
Anson Smith's and the other one, Carolyn Ammons. I don't know the rest of them.
So it looks like it's $1.75 a gallon.
But this is fine and dandy, but it doesn't say how much he uses, how much he needs. It just tells us what the price is, how many gallons. Well, it doesn't account for, I'm being told that he's got a tank full down there already. But that nowhere here does it say, I have a tank full already. The culvert's the same thing. He ordered 7 of them, and the bill hasn't come in yet. So I asked him outright, I said, well, how many culverts did you put in this year? But he didn't give me an answer. So
7 culverts is probably somewhere around $4,500.
Around
$4,500? Right.
Again, so, I mean, this, to me, it wasn't helpful because it didn't tell me what he has, or like you said, I mean, this is great information if I want to know how much it costs per gallon, but it doesn't tell how many gallons we use,
right,
or how many roads he's done and how many roads he needs to do.
So technically what you really want is an inventory.
That'd be helpful.
Basically.
That would be helpful. But not just an inventory too, Jenny. Like, if he's got 12, I know that Bobby Bassett used to have a large inventory of culverts. But he could tell us where he intended those culverts to go. So we knew they were going to sit in inventory, that we're going to actually have a home. So, this is good information, but I didn't find it helpful for trying to determine what the needs are.
No, yeah, I get it. Even if you drop down to the fuel, you can see there's 22-cent increase projected. However, it doesn't say how many gallons that should be.
And I think every question we asked him, every question he said, what about this? And he'd say, well, I don't know what the price is going to be in the spring. Well, none of us know what the price is going to be in the spring. You know, so you got to look right now. And I think your mindset, Russell, too, is to think about X amount percentage increase because you know that it's going to be 3% more or whatever.
Guarantee that his budget's going to be 3.7% more. That's just
right.
The way it is. And here's another thing, too, is, look, I work with him for a short period of time, so I know where his deficiencies are when it comes to certain things. A lot of his deficiency is in equipment. But equipment doesn't necessarily go in your budget. Equipment is something that you ask for because it's a one-time thing for, say, 10 years. It goes in a CIP. Especially if it's a lot of this equipment, I mean, a sander is $30,000. Well, one of the best working sanders we have is from 1980s. So if they're going to last that long, it doesn't go in here. That stuff needs to be asked for by way of an article, in my opinion. And it should be planned accordingly by a capital improvements plan.
Well, I guess at this point, I think, just so that we don't hold you up forever, too, is I guess if you could just guide us and go down that list of his and say if you think it's realistic. And then, I mean, the board has not made any decisions whatsoever, but we need a little bit of information because we can make decisions.
Sure.
And if you, I mean, I don't know, like I said, I think you're write to Russell that he just plugs figures in, because maybe that's what it was before.
Well, he's new and he's busy.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I get it.
I did offer free of charge to set up inventories for him for all his repairs.
Yes, that was a very good idea.
Well, how can you go to the voters and ask for a new piece of equipment if you can't if you can't justify the expenses and the repairs that you've done? I mean,
so let's start with Clara. And I can't help but compare it to 2023, because we have absolutely nothing
to go on.
So we can't just come up with a figure without knowing how many gallons he uses, how many gallons per mile, how many miles of road there are, and how often he does it. So I can say that in 2023, it was at $8,500 is what the appropriation was. The amount spent was zero. I would feel comfortable with giving him back $8,500. You know,
he felt $6,000 would be adequate.
Okay, well, if he says six,
that's what he told us that night. That
then six. I mean, without having him sitting here saying something, I mean,
he has the opportunity to come back before us once we do any types of adjustments. They all do. Every department head has that opportunity.
Sure.
And he can tell us if we're late off base.
Did he say, culverts is the next line item. Did he say anything about any future culvert projects or anything like that?
He just said, I think he said, I had written out number seven, so I think he told us he has purchased seven. But he hasn't gotten the bill for them.
Right.
And I don't, have they come in yet? I don't know if they've come in yet.
He also, I recall, had seven from last year, but I don't know if he's done anything with those.
We call a couple being replaced that we have, I can't then say.
Okay, so we could use them.
A couple. I don't know.
So we use 18-inch culverts. 18-inch culverts for the majority of what we do. I think on average they're anywhere from $500 to $800 is what I've seen for prices in different places for them. I don't know if the town needs any kind of a break. I know that the town municipalities usually get breaks on taxes, but I don't see how a culvert is taxed. So I'm not sure if they get breaks.
Yeah, that's how they.
How much did you say it was?
$500 to $800.
He put down $565.80.
Okay, so it's on the low side. If he ordered seven already, is that seven going to come out of his budget now, or is it going to come out of his budget next year? If it comes out of his budget now,
it's coming out of this year because it's already allotted.
He says, and it won't take, like I said, it shouldn't take 2 months to get a bill.
I mean, I know that there's a couple of spots he definitely needs culverts. So there's definitely two of them that are going to be hopefully replaced next year.
So do you think that the $5,000 that he asked for this past year should be adequate if he gets these seven and if he takes the money out of this year's account?
I would think that if he's paying for seven already this year, the $5,000 should be adequate. Because that's going to give him another 8.
Right.
And that's at the
high end. Right. Not the smaller ones.
Didn't $3,000 come out of the culvert budget to pay for the new truck?
Not that I'm aware of.
No?
I believe it came out of patch and
That was $20,000. I had that $2,797 came out of culverts and $20,000 came out of paving.
Well, if it came out of culverts, then the amount spent would say $2,700.
Right. So he said that the DOT testing could drop down to $800.
What is the DOT testing?
That's where it's
random
urine test, blood test.
That's something you're not
say given it to, if that 800 would be adequate. The fuel.
So this is where I have a hard problem, a hard time, is fuel. 2023, they asked for 40,000. Amount spent so far this year, 16,800. And for 2024, he's asking for 50,000.
And that's what, I think Ed brought that up too, said the fuel went down, right?
No, okay.
Not his fuel.
He uses Evans.
Oh, and he insists on, he doesn't want to change from Evans.
They're there every day. And that fuel is diesel for the trucks.
But how do we go from 16,800 so far this year when we have, what do we have, 2 months?
Yeah.
2.5 months left?
Rain.
It is rain, yeah, lots of rain.
He did say, though, 40,000. Is that what you got? That he agreed to 40,000 instead of 50?
And that puts him back to his 2023 asking amount or to that
right.
Appropriation. I don't see a problem with that.
I figured about 12,000 for 3 more months, looking at the figures that had been spent
yeah.
on the date. So.
I think you'd be safe there.
The heating oil, I guess, is what he argued that he really needed the 11,000.
Right, because it's not locked in. It's in
yeah,
right.
Yeah. All the evidence is there.
Right.
So can we change that?
Well, he was pretty adamant. It wasn't
right.
going to change.
Yeah.
Why?
Because he felt very comfortable with the responsibility level of them delivering the fuel in addition to the quality.
Right.
Innovation. No difference. Innovation delivered every month.
Delivering fuel
probably
to houses every day.
Like $2 a gallon cheaper, probably.
Well, I think his argument also was that he's never had any problem with them and that he was comfortable.
Evans.
Yeah,
Evans has been delivering to Grafton for what? Ever since Johnny Bassett was in.
Yeah, like 2012 issues with
them. Like I said, you got something that works, don't fix it.
Well, my feeling is that we should shop around, but I think it's a little late to do it this year.
Right.
But I
yeah.
think that maybe going into next year, we should really push to have that looked at.
So is Evans fuel any more expensive in 2024
than
2023?
Yeah, I think it was. It was more than what the town was paying.
Mm-hmm.
Locked in there.
Again, without knowing how many gallons he spends and what the price is going to be, we're just throwing a number out there.
Right, and I think that it's realistic to look at it for next year, but for this year, I think we're just too late into the season and
yes,
being able to lock in. You'd pay a heck of a lot more.
Yes.
See, I'd probably just give him what he wants on that one.
Well, I can understand. If you get fuel from somebody, whether it's, I mean, like my car, I go to a certain place because my car likes that gas and it runs well on.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if they have a day when their truck is there and they're fueling up and you need gas, you're not going to fill it that day because it's going to be riled up. So you go someplace else. My car doesn't like that. It gives me trouble.
Can I just go back to fuel for a second? Now,
fuel.
That's the fuel.
Yeah, okay.
So there are other departments that go to them and fill their tanks, is that correct?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought the other night when we were reviewing some other budgets that our department had said that they had not received a bill from Jeffrey. Now, is that how it works? He charges that department?
Right. Yes.
All he does is he lets Sarah know and the department head know how many gallons they used and how much it cost.
Mm-hmm.
So then the money for that fuel comes out of that department, not out of his money.
Okay. So one of the it is possible that this may be an inflated figure given the fact that...
Well, this is for his department. This isn't for everybody else's department.
No, I understand that. But I'm saying, though, if he's picking up the cost for the fuel...
He is. He's only paying for his own. So I'll give you a good example. He buys diesel. Mm-hmm. Everybody else uses gas. The only thing he's going to use gas in is the one green truck that they have. And maybe a lawnmower or something if they do a chainsaw. So they don't front the money for the other departments.
Oh, okay.
That money is strictly for their department.
Okay. Thank you. For
sure.
Then the painting and patching. That seems to be a real issue. So what he told us is that the reason it's a zero spent this year, he did do patching, he said, and paving. But he said he had stockpiled coal patch. I always get that confused. Coal patch. And so that, in fact, he had done coal patching around town, but he'd used his stockpile. And that's why it's a zero.
Yep.
So,
I think it should be split. I think that paving should be a line,
yes.
And patching should be a line. Yeah, it should not be lumped together because it's confusing.
Because one is a maintenance item, which you need every year, mm-hmm. and the other one is a wish list.
Well, the thing that struck me is when I said, well, what are you talking about paving? And he said his goal is to pave Turnpike Road from where the state ends to Millbrook Bridge, Millbrook. So now we're talking different philosophy than the board has taken in the past, because in the past, the board has said that paving needed to be used for repairing the paved roads.
This is maintenance. This is a budget for every year. This isn't for paving a road which is going to last 12 years. That would be on
a special warrant article.
A special warrant article.
Okay.
In a capital improvements plan.
So that kind of information for me is important for the board to say. We're not going to support that because that makes a difference in how we're going to make our recommendation. Whereas if the board says, oh, no, we've already told him he can pave that portion of dirt road, then again, that's going to change my opinion. So those are the kinds of things
and
I was looking for.
Don't get me wrong. I think that advancing,
yes.
100 feet up a dirt road after you do the proper prep work is advantageous for the town. In a 30-year span, because it's a lot cheaper to maintain paved roads than it is dirt roads.
But in the meantime, we've got a lot of paved roads that are in bad shape.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my question, because the board has the time to say.
I understand what he's trying to do, which is commendable.
Yeah.
But he's going about it potentially the wrong way. It should be the warrant article for any hardcore paving.
And he has a warrant article, $75,000 for warrant article.
Sure.
So how would you like it to find in that new paper that I gave you with the line items? Just separated out, paving, patching? Do you want any more words added to either one of those?
I think that... when he has this paving, if he has a line item that says paving, he just would, like other road agents before him, use the paving line item along with the warrant item.
Right.
And that's what I believe.
The only thing I can think of is
the problem with doing from the town line to Millbrook Road is he won't be paving it. If he don't want to do it this year, he won't be paving this year.
No, it's
you have to tear the concrete. Well, next year you won't be doing it next year because you got to tear the concrete.
Gas
off. Redo the culverts the whole way. Build the road again. Let it set in here. There's going to be 2 years before you can even think about paving the first layer.
Yeah.
that's not the case with another area in town where
it's already paved.
And it's already paved, you can usually just do a skin coat. They do like a 2-inch coat over line.
So, I mean, it's reasonable to say he does need patching.
Oh, absolutely.
Full patch.
Yep.
So,
always need patching.
Right. So is 20,000 realistic for cold patch, or is that wait?
I have no idea what cold patch costs.
What he said for cold patch was that $1,000 would be more than.
Oh, 1,000?
Yeah, that's
okay,
what
I
he said.
I didn't hear that.
Yes. And right. He said the rest would be used for paving.
Gotcha. But, okay. Phone internet is. He justified that increase because, of course, he wants to get onto the internet.
Yeah, and you should.
Very reasonable.
Absolutely. He has to fiber.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he uses his hotspot on his phone right now.
The, I guess my question is parts, repairs, et cetera, that's a huge increase. And what was the, because this is a selectman's recommendation, 73,000.
No. 73,000 is his request.
Oh, because it says board is like, oh, I see, because Sarah handed this to us as is, because you and Jenny didn't come to the consensus that night. Okay. So, having said that, and again, this is so hard because he doesn't have any history where he could tell us. Yeah, I think Sandy was the one that said, well, how much have you spent on repairs for the grader this year? And he couldn't tell us because he hasn't really, you know, kept track. Only that it's cost a lot and that it's down again, which we all understand.
Repairs for machinery are expensive.
Of course they are.
And we have paid a lot, the whole machine. That's what we do our work with.
Realistically, he had 58 and he spent 52.7, almost 53,000.
Well, he said it was up to.
Oh, that's right. It was 60 something now.
It seems to me that because of the equipment being as aged as it is, number one, you know, like I hate saying $52,000 or $63,000 being appropriated, and last year it was just as high being appropriated to working on this, number one, and paying all of this expenses year after year. So that would reduce his bottom line budget. Not by 50,000 completely, but close to it. And in addition, not only are they paying for parts, but they're also taking people
off the road
to
work on equipment.
And you're using wages to repair mm-hmm. equipment. And he did say that, because I asked him, he said 95% of maintenance they do themselves mm-hmm. on the equipment.
Think about what it would cost if you sent it
sure.
out.
Yeah, and he did say because of the age of the equipment that its parts are obsolete, you have to really hunt for them, and they cost more. And I know that from personal experience with something I was trying to repair. So it seems to me that a very logical approach would be to start purchasing new equipment. And I know you said he needs a capital improvement plan, and that's mm-hmm. one of the issues I had, that nowhere in this budget did he have any money set aside for doing exactly that. But he did also say that he had a lead on a 2012 grader for $95,000. And he does have some money in his budget, I think between now and year end, where it might be possible to do that. Money can be diverted.
Problem with used equipment.
They gave it up for a reason.
Is it used equipment? Mm-hmm. We have a problem now. We have used equipment. No, I mean, as of right now, he's asking for $75,000 for repairs. You get another piece of used equipment in there. Did we just save anything on repairs? I don't know. If it's new, yeah, sure. You might be able to, if we knew how much the grader cost, you might be able to take $20,000 out of that.
How about leasing? I don't know what the market is like.
It's all the same. So a municipal lease is probably the smartest way to go. So does it really cost you nothing? And they don't care if you maintain it or not. You're essentially, you're buying it. But I propose it. You know what I mean? Let me see it. Let me see what's, and how's it going to change these numbers.
Do I remember correctly that last year there was in the budget there was something to do with loan, borrowing money, and it was the anticipated interest, I guess. We had a line item for that. Do we have a line of credit for the town?
Jenny, you can explain it better, but I don't think we've actually borrowed money.
Not anymore.
And paid interest in a long time.
They don't put it.
So.
They dropped a can.
Right.
I don't know.
That's what
I was talking
about.
They used what for?
Yep.
Or they, oh, okay.
Yep. Supposedly
it was
the bank, they didn't need it anymore because we hadn't borrowed it in so long.
Oh, it's been years since we, yeah.
Yeah, so we didn't appropriate, we didn't ask to appropriate anything for that.
And actually, back when we used to ask the 10, it basically was we were afraid that we were going to run out of tax money. It's when we,
right,
when we billed once a year, and we felt we needed, we might need to borrow money to get us through the year.
Sometimes we did.
Yeah, but that's what the 10 was originally for, the anticipation that we weren't going to collect enough tax money.
So, without any more, without any knowledge as to what is going to break, or, you know, what's the equipment like and versus what it was like last year, I don't know that it's any worse than it was in 2020, other than being a year older. And some of it actually was maintained or fixed.
Oh, plus we have one new truck, a new highway truck.
Right, which is brand new, but it was also brand new in 23.
Yeah.
So the money should have been appropriated really for that.
For repairs, right?
I don't know. I don't know why the increase from 23, other than your standard pay parts, are a little bit more now.
When we talked about salt with him, he had asked, he had $6,000 last year. He spent almost $11,500, and so he was asking for $20,000 this time around. And again, he said he overspent his